on tonight's episode of Who Wants to Be Insane? Which one of our remaining top three contestants will win a stay in the luxurious Botanica Hotel after being proven completely nuts? Will it be Father Reverend Lokodo and his obsession for miniskirts and pornography? Or will it be the Nigerian Francis Ombolo something? Okay, Desire's ex-lover, that one who posted a sex tape. I mean, what else did you expect from him? Or will it be Uganda police and Interpol for not being sure whether the person was arrested or not? After last week's eviction of Elias Lukwago, find out on tonight's episode of Who Wants to Be Insane? So by now, I don't have to reiterate the fact that Lokodo messed up. Or not, we are still not sure. All we know is that he said Francis Wombo, that Nigerian Desire's ex-lover, had been arrested, and then it turns out this video is released.
The minister said I'm in jail. Imagine a whole minister of a country misleading the people, the saying video. That, yes, I'm in jail. My brother, come this way and tell them. Are we in jail?
My brother, we are having fun. Like,
that
minister, be warned. We are coming.
Ended like a typical Nigerian movie. So the Nigerian guy says he's free. He is out there. He's having a ball. And he does not know what the heck we are talking about. He even tries to speak Luganda. In a very annoying kind of way. But here is the thing. Tonight we're trying to figure out exactly who went wrong so we can send them to prison and or a mental institution, because you don't just make mistakes like that. It's an international scandal, man. It's a big deal. I mean, it's us against Nigeria. There's more of them, both in film and in reality. So we really cannot compete with their 500 million population or something. Nigeria is like the China of Africa. So we are going to find out exactly whose fault it was, and in order. Number one, there's Reverend Francis Lokodo, Minister for Ethics and Integrity, or lack thereof, because his obsession with miniskirts makes me wonder, is he against them or for them? Man loves his porn to the point where he's supervising it. But that's a story for another day. So we're asking, so he claims he had Desire's ex-lover arrested on charges of distributing pornography and spoiling young children, including Desire. Lol. So here is our theory. The fact that the Nigerian claims is not in jail right now could mean Lokodo, being a man of God, saw a vision of himself arresting Desire's ex-lover and took it as gospel truth and is now preaching about the future, we think. Or maybe he just had a dream where he really, really, really wanted to catch this guy so bad it manifested in his head and now it's become his reality. I hope we have Botanica on speed dial for that. Secondly, there's the Nigerian, Francis Wombolo. I mean, okay, fine. I can't pronounce his name, but at least I got the first part right, which explains the sex tapes. I mean, what do you expect from a guy whose name has Bolo in it? Who claims that he has not been arrested? Now, chances are he was in jail at some point, then released and flew back to Nigeria, because it's like a 4-5 hour flight to Nigeria, any airline. So probably he was in jail and now he's not. Or maybe he's not aware that he's in jail, yet he was arrested.
Are we in jail?
My brother, we are having fun, like crazy fun here.
They could have arrested him, thrown him into a stuffy, dark room with dim lighting and lots of people. In Nigeria, that could easily be mistaken for a club, considering the population. We don't know. He's probably sending his message from a jail, and that guy he called was a Ugandan faking a Nigerian accent.
What are you talking about? How can you talk about jail?
Come on, people, we do that all the time. Just darken the video a little.
What are you talking about? How can you talk about jail?
And then third, there's the police, who don't exactly have the best track record, if I may say. I mean, these are guys during the Sejusa saga who went to a media house looking for an email in file cabinets. With that being said, We can't be sure if they didn't actually have him in custody and just denied it, or took a bribe and set him free, or they just went ahead and arrested the wrong person. We can't be sure. For all we know, maybe they didn't recognize Desire's ex-lover with his clothes on. I mean, if you identify a guy from a sex tape, it's a bit difficult when he dresses up. Or maybe they arrested Farouk, Zari's ex-lover. They have a bit of a similarity in appearance. No, the face, not thingy. Yeah, and probably Farouk's idea of prison is being put in clothes. We are really not sure. So we are going to keep investigating to find out exactly who went wrong, at what point, and why. For now, we recommend they all be sent to Butabika. So who gets the 5-star accommodation and luxury of Butabika Hospital for a very long time? Will it be Lokodo, the obsessive father? Oh, Francis, Desire's ex-lover and porn activist. Or will it be the police and Interpol, who have a track record for human rights violations and incredibly stupid mistakes in investigations? Find out on our next episode of Who Wants to Be Insane?